Greetings, Brother Bashar. You ask a great question, my friend. Bro, I've read the Bible and I've read the Quran. You do the same and you tell me what Muhammad's goal was. Here is my response in video form, Bashar. It is impossible for one man to know the heart of another man. Specifically, I cannot know what Muhammad planned as he either wrote the Quran or cooperated in writing the Quran under the guidance of a supernatural influence. Keep in mind, this does not necessarily mean God. It may mean a demon, or Satan himself, or some other form of spirit. If you have read the Bible and paid attention while you did so, you should have learned that, number one, God's name is Yahweh. Exodus 6:3, I appeared to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob as God Almighty, but by my name, the Lord, Yahweh, I did not make myself fully known to them. Psalm 135:1, Hallelujah! Praise the name of Yahweh! Give praise, you servants of Yahweh! Point 2. God's opposition, Lucifer, or Satan, or the devil, struggled to claim he would set his throne above the throne of God. Isaiah 14:12, How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning? How art thou cut down to the ground, who didst weaken the nations? And you said in your heart, I will ascend to heaven, I will exalt my throne above the stars of God. I will sit upon the mount of assembly in the uttermost north. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will make myself like the Most High. Point 3. You should have learned that God declared He was the Redeemer of mankind and would redeem us from our sins. Job 19:25. For I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. Psalm 19:14. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord Yahweh, my strength and my Redeemer. Isaiah 41:14. Fear not, thou worm Jacob, and you men of Israel, I will help thee, saith the Lord Yahweh, and thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. Isaiah 44:22, I have blotted out as a thick cloud thy transgressions, and as a cloud thy sins. Return unto me, for I have redeemed thee. Isaiah 54:5, For thy Maker is thy husband, the Lord Yahweh of hosts is his name, and thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel, the God of the whole earth shall he be called. And in the New Testament we learn who the Redeemer is. Matthew 20:28, Just as the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life a ransom for many. Ephesians 1:7, In him, this is speaking of Jesus, we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses, or sins, according to the riches of his grace. 1 Corinthians 1:30, But by his doing you are in Christ Jesus, who became to us wisdom from God and righteousness and sanctification and redemption. Luke 1:68, Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, who has visited and redeemed his people. 1 Peter 1:18, Forasmuch as you know that you were not redeemed with corruptible things, as silver and gold, from your vain conversation received by tradition from your fathers, but with the precious blood of Christ, as of a lamb without blemish and without spot. Revelation 5:9, And they sung a new song, saying, Thou art worthy to take the book and to open the seals thereof, for thou wast slain and hast redeemed us to God by thy blood, out of every kindred and tongue and people and nation. Point 4. You should have learned that the prophets spoke of the Son of God. Psalm 2:7, I will declare the decree the Lord Yahweh has said unto me, Thou art my son, this day have I begotten thee. Proverbs 34, Who has ascended up into heaven or descended? Who has gathered the wind in his fists, and who has bound the waters in a garment? Who has established all the ends of the earth? What is his name, and what is his son's name, if you can tell? Isaiah 9:6, For a child will be born unto us, a son will be given to us, and the government will rest on his shoulders, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Father, Prince of Peace. 5. You should have learned that the prophets said Yahweh would come to the earth. Job 19:25 again, For I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. Isaiah 43, The voice of him that cries in the wilderness, Prepare ye the way of the Lord, Yahweh, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Couple this with Yahweh being the Redeemer, and Jesus being the Redeemer. 6. You should have learned of the hundreds of predictions about Messiah. 7. You should have read that the Jews themselves thought the Messiah would be the Son of God. Mark 14:61, But he, and this is speaking of Jesus, remained silent and made no answer. Again the high priest asked him, Are you the Christ, the Son of the Blessed? These are but a few of the many things you should have found written in the pages of God's Word, the Bible. But one of the most important things you should have learned while reading the Bible, brother, is that Jesus was crucified for our sin. Jesus was the Lamb of God. Jesus was Yahweh come to earth as the prophets foretold. Jesus is the promised Redeemer of mankind from our sins. This salvation offered by God is free to all mankind if you will but accept the free gift and believe in the Son of God. You asked me, Bro, tell me what Mohammed's goal was. The goal of the author of the Quran is to deny you this salvation by way of deception, brother. There is no force in this universe which can stop you once you decide to follow the Son of God. However, if Satan can deceive you and convince you that the offer of salvation was not legitimate, if Satan can trick you into rejecting the Son of God, you will reject God's salvation. Then he, Satan, condemns you to hell. This is the goal of the author of the Quran. Islam teaches you, no, commands you, believe it or else. Islam requires you believe it by assumption, but Islam offers no actual evidence. So, Brother Bashar, it is important for you to understand the real message of the prophets. Begin by confirming every scripture I quoted exists and is correctly stated. If you have any questions, Brother Bashar, please ask. There is no question which God cannot answer. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.